finances here, we're so glad you're here. We love God's children, we love his saints. We do owe it to one another to love one another, don't we? And to feel the sweet spirit of the Lord. I personally would rather feel the spirit of the Lord, feel his covering on me than anything that I can think of. Can you? And he said that he would always be with us, no matter where, what was happening, to the end of the world. He said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you.
Amen.
He said, I'll be with you all the way.
All the way.
To the end of the world.
Amen.
Blessed
Amen.
Be his precious name. Amen. Amen. Our God Amen. Is such a loving God. He loved the world. He said, so loved the world that he gave his only son. Human words cannot even describe the great love that our Father, the Father of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, Father, our God, has for this world. And Scripture said, talking about the wicked, he said, do I have any pleasure at the death of the wicked? He said, would I not rather that he turn from his ways and serve me and live? I was going along one day with two little boys in a truck, and they were seeing on my job, and they was one of them seeing just how ugly and that he could talk, and the other one, and I was sitting between them, and the other one was over here doing the same thing, and I was in between them, you know.
Yeah.
Everything you could think of being said.
Bless you, Jesus.
And I said, boys, I read about y'all last night, everything got real quiet. I said, the Lord really loves y'all. I said, I read about you, and I just shut up. That's the way it went. And everything got real quiet, and I said, well, what'd you read, you know? I said, I read in the scriptures where that the Lord doesn't have any pleasure at the death of the wicked, but he would rather see him turn from his
Amen,
ways, serve me, and live. And everything got quiet, and the Spirit of the Lord came in that truck. And the Spirit of the Lord came in like it just drove away all that evil. You know, later on in life, those two fellas got it right with the Lord. Now they live as close as they want to with the Lord, but they both started going to church, and both of them claims to be saved.
Amen, brother Frank.
All right, praise the Lord. I thank God for that. God loves his children. He loves them. He loves this whole world. How much could he love? He can't love Brother Marlowe better than he loves me.
Right.
And he can't love me better than he loves anybody else. He's already loved us with a love that can't even be comprehended by giving his precious dear son, the jewel of all heaven and all of earth, he gave him. Praise his loving name.
Amen.
Oh, do y'all like to feel the Spirit of the Lord? Raise your hand.
Yes,
hallelujah.
Have to yell or scream and feel
Father,
it.
Father, I praise you, Lord.
I just like to move my hands around. It feels like I can just feel it, can't y'all? Sometimes I just, when I get to praying, I just like to feel his sweet presence. Just get real, real close to him. Praise his loving, sweet name. And, you know, there was, I was just thinking the other day, you know, the Lord, as one brother said one time, that it doesn't impress God for us to tell him we love him, but you know what? He likes to hear it. It might not impress him, but God loves to hear us look up to him and say, Father, I thank you for your son, Jesus Christ. Brother Marlowe was talking before church to me. We wouldn't have anything if it hadn't been for Jesus Christ. This world wouldn't be even a feasible, it wouldn't even be a planet that we could live on, had it not been for our Savior,
That's right.
Jesus Christ. And God gave us that wonderful, wonderful person, Jesus Christ. And like I said, it's a wonderful thing to know that he loves us, and we tell him that we love him, and we feel his presence, and it is important to God. You take God as He is unexplainable. He is from everlasting unto everlasting. He lives in eternity. There's no words can express how wonderful and great he is. Yet he delights in the prayers of his saints. Blessed be his precious name. He absolutely, in your prayers are very important to God Almighty.
Yes.
He loves to hear your voice.
Yes.
Now, if that don't make you want to pray, nothing will. I mean, the fact that when you go before the Lord, he loves to hear you. He loves you. It don't matter what's went on or what hasn't went on. He loves us with all of his heart, and he's open and ready to love us and just continue to love us. But there is a difference in how much somebody wants to love the Lord and how close they want to get to Jesus Christ. Praise his loving name. And just like John the Beloved, he was always over there where Jesus was, laying his head against Jesus' his breast, wasn't he? And he was just always so close to the Lord. And the rest of the disciples, they were jealous of him because he was always over there close to him. But Jesus made a statement one time, said, "O Jerusalem, O Jerusalem, how often would I have gathered you as a hen with her brood, but you would not." And in other words, John was over there next to Jesus because he wanted to get closer to Jesus Christ. And all the rest of the disciples, they could have been over there too. Do you think Jesus would have pushed Peter away? Tell me, do you think he would have pushed him away while John was laying against Jesus' breast and Peter said, "Lord, I want to come over there and lay right there beside of you and lay my head up against your breast"? You think Jesus would have pushed Peter away? I tell you, no, he wouldn't have pushed him away. He wouldn't have pushed any of his disciples away, but he would have just gathered them up, just like he said he would Jerusalem. Blessed be his precious holy name. I thank God that we can just get as close to the Lord as we want to. I don't want to love the Lord from way off across the room or across the world, but I want to get just as close to him as I possibly can and to love him with all of my heart. Blessed be his precious name. And you know, I just use your common sense. The Bible, I don't think it says anything about this, but especially when a child is little and is sleeping with mom and dad, and if the mom and dad gets up, it disturbs that child, and this child will wake up. And or in my case, I got a little dog that sleeps beside me a lot of times, and it knows when it's time for me to pray. Somewhere or another, the Spirit of the Lord will come in that room, and my little dog, I feel the Spirit of the Lord web in the night, want me to get up and pray. And I don't know what for a lot of times, but my little dog was, believe it or not, I mean, it's the truth, she feels the Spirit of the Lord. And she will not leave me alone until I get up and I go pray. I mean, he'll just do everything in the world until finally I say, "Lord, I'll go pray." And I go up there and I begin to pray and get as close to the Lord as I possibly can. Praise his loving name. We can get just as close to the Lord as we want to. Blessed be his loving, sweet, precious name. I love him tonight, and we're to love one another with all of our heart. Thank God for being here. Thank God for this wonderful service. Looking forward to hearing all of our brothers preach, all of our sisters, and just have a wonderful time in the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.